You're listening to The Mentality Show, only on LA Talk Radio.
Oh, what's going on, people? Southern California, what's good? This is Casey. I'm on The Mentality Show. Next to me is Hater One. No, I'm joking. It's Leah and three perverts.
That's right. Perverted.
So men are perverts. I never thought that.
Really?
How's everybody doing? How was your weeks?
Hey, week is great, man.
My week was good. Hold on, wait. Men are perverts. You went to Men Are Perverts, and then how was your week? I'm very like gearshift.
I know that was very
random. Yeah. That was not the introduction move.
You know
so
what's
I
going
feel
on.
Like
I think he's
I do,
thinking
he's
about
very
something
upset.
Perverted. And
listen,
he just
let me
thought,
just tell
like,
you
I'm
guys
perverted.
Right. Like pregame, we had a conversation about football, and he said all
Jesus.
His feelings about it.
You knew she was gonna do this shit.
And here we go. And he told me we weren't done talking about it, so I feel like he's still like he can't get over it yet, and it's fine. He's honest. He won't even like eye contact with me. Look at him. He turned his whole head around, broke his whole neck, and said, "Yes, I will."
Whiplash.
That was not the introduction move.
Was that?
Was that me?
No, that was me.
Hello.
Whoops.
Okay, let's start the show. We got Texi, me,
up?
Casey, Leah, and the one Vato V. Dale knows the way a little bit right now. He's at a convention with, it looks like, men who. Like they're really smart.
Yes.
Like there's no alcohol in the vicinity.
Nope. Not for him. No.
Oh yeah, that's right. I would love to see Delano drunk.
I would love to see him drunk.
He acted drunk. He had like a shot once, half a shot, and then he acted drunk.
He had a shot of Bartles and James.
I feel like, see, like, it doesn't take me much either, though. I'm not a very big drinker, so when I have a shot, I'm like, where are we eating? But I'm always like, where are we eating next?
But okay,
like,
so you take a shot, it has to go into your system, right? He, like, instantly started acting like he was drunk.
Oh, no, you know that's like, no, that's like one of the like, women who, like, peed on the stick, found out she's pregnant. She's like, I need pickles and ice cream. It's like, no, you don't. No, you don't. Not until, like, 9 months.
Yeah. He didn't have the time for the process yet.
I got you. Okay.
He peed on a stick.
I was trying to be optimistic, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was trying to be like, okay, well, I have one shot. And sometimes I'm a little bit like, woohoo. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
don't try to cover for him.
I was really trying to be sweet. I don't drink a lot. I'm not a big drinker.
You seem like you can handle your booze.
I mean, I can handle it. I just talk about food a lot afterwards. Like, I'm very on the
So
like,
you're one of those. You're
like,
a munchies.
I laugh, and then I'm like, where are we eating? And then I'm like, no, seriously. Like, let's plan this. And then I'll laugh the rest of the night.
I'm really trying to post this, but you know, my mind's fucked up right now. Listen.
You see what I'm saying, people? I tried to address it earlier. Oh,
okay.
He shut me down. Here he goes again. This is
so
what
we had college football this weekend. Anybody watch any football?
We didn't watch
of course we did.
I watched my Dodgers.
You know
yeah,
I did.
Too. I did too.
What game
San
did you
Francisco
catch?
Hurt a little bit, but they picked it up against the Cardinals. Two wins. I love it.
Yes.
They play tonight, right?
They're playing right now.
We're in playoff field. It's getting there.
Mm-hmm. We're good.
Get
good.
Kershaw healthy. I think I like the squad.
Uh-oh.
That's me.
Is that me again?
No, it's me.
It's okay.
I think I like the squad, but you know, it's a marathon. It's long. Do they have professional baseball in Alabama?
They don't. See, so this is why we have like
football.
That's what we do.
That's all you got.
Really well. Execution.
Wow. College football.
It's okay. That's like Arkansas. All they have is football.
You know what? See, I knew you were on top of games with me. You said it's like Arkansas. No, you already know it's not like Arkansas. You already know it's nothing like Arkansas. It's nothing like Arkansas, people. Mm-mm.
Do any projects this week? How's your week?
You see me? Y'all see how he does me? Because I'm an Alabama fan. Because we win. You see how he does me? I see it. Okay. That's fine.
Alabama, baby.
Alabama. All right, it's fine.
I'm done.
Where are you? Look, y'all heard it. He said he was done. If he brings it back up, he ain't done.
We are brought to you by Beloria and Malukian LLP. Let me tell you something. You want to talk about quality? You want to talk about consistency?
Mm-hmm. Professionalism?
Work hardism?
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
This is Beloria and Malukian.
Yeah. Uh-huh. What's the number?
747-444-444.
Four, four.
There it is.
Personal injury, wrongful death, accidental.
Mm-hmm.
What's the fire when they fire people? Wrongful
firing.
I didn't know it was that valuable.
Wrongful termination.
I was shocked when I saw the check for what, $400,000+?
Wow.
You better be careful. Hey, you guys want a good lawyer? These guys right here, man. Lawyer Luke, you know,
they're the best.
They're the awesome.
They fight for you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, they do.
That's what's
they
up.
Do. And then they
that's all you need.
They make sure your wishes come true.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Lawyer and Malukian.
Hell yeah.
All right, let's start the show.
Start the show.
Well, today we're supposed to talk about how can men improve a marriage.
Okay.
This is a little bit more serious than a relationship.
Agreed.
I'm not married, but I can give good advice to married people.
Okay. I like the energy.
Anybody here married?
I'm married.
Married.
I was.
Oh. There it is. He has experience in the field.
To shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Good marriage. Goodbye. Yeah. End the show. Goodbye.
Yeah, yeah. Be a good boy. Yeah. Marriage is hard, man. I think marriage is hard, and trying to, when you're in a relationship, obviously you're going to be monogamous for the rest of your life. So mm-hmm. you got to please that person in whatever way you can possibly please them. And sometimes you get into a marriage thinking, wow, she's a beautiful person, but then you start getting to know them in a different way. It's like, oh shit, did I marry the right person?
And right.
I think, you don't. I think the best advice is to live with them before you get married.
I agree with that.
Because mm-hmm. people are different when you live with them.
Mm-hmm. But you know, the thing is that sometimes, you know, we fall in love with obviously the physical. And when they tell you fall in love with what's on the inside instead of the outside, now that you get older, it's like, oh shit, you're right. You know what I mean? Because you don't know what the fuck they're thinking on the inside. And, you know, maybe that's why we failed in my relationship. But mm-hmm. maybe it was me. I don't know.
Yeah.
So shit happens. Shit happens.
I was definitely him. Like, I don't know what y'all mean. It was definitely him. My first marriage I failed. Yeah, it was definitely him. Well, what, me at all? Per my second marriage, which is going fine.
It's about men. What men mess up in marriages, they don't feel and understand what women are going through.
You know what? I have to say to men, I'm going to be honest with you. As a woman, and this is one thing I think women can relate to, one thing that I think men do not understand in the dating field. Do not approach a woman as the man that you want to be, you want to become, because mm-hmm. that's hard to keep up. And women, same advice. Go as you are. If you have kids or if you have baggage or you have whatever else, don't let it come out later. Like, you don't have to go sit down first night and map out your whole life, right? But what I'm saying is like, if you meet the representative of someone who, like, have you ever met somebody and then, like, 3 months in, you feel like they change so much, but it's only because they can't keep up this facade that they've created. You meet the representative is what I'm saying.
I agree.
You could, so when you come and you be honest, preach that all day long, but people don't do that.
Yeah,
people never do that. People can always put their best foot forward. And
well, you should.
And then...
But honestly,
let the asshole out after they're comfortable. Yeah.
Well, you want to like you said, you want to come at somebody with, you know, be the best that you can possibly be. And you're not going to tell them like, oh, by the way, I'm a piece of shit. And
it's like farting. You don't have a fart on the first date.
Exactly.
But give it six months.
Like, no, like I don't do that. My husband. I've been married for a long time. We have children. I still like, no, here's the thing. When we first met, like the first night, I told him, I was like, look, I'm crazy. Like, you lie to me, you'll catch these hands. I don't care. I don't care who you are. Call your police friends. I don't care. Do it. I don't care. You know what I mean? Like, no, I'm Italian and I'm crazy. It was like, you run that risk. Like, it's like driving a Ferrari versus a very comfortable Honda Civic.
You just said you would catch these hands, but would you take it back if a hand came back?
Not at all. Then we just gonna fight. You gonna break these nails and pay for it too. Like, you run that later. Risk as a woman. But I'm okay if you well, come and ask me out, then grab a knife. That
because some women think they can strike a man and not get hit back.
Yeah. No, I'll duck. I'm cool. Okay. I'm comfortable. Okay. We'll square up. He's like five. Like, we're like close to the same height. It's cool.
But that's the thing though. Like, how is it that like a lot of women, you know, they get mad at their man and it's okay for them to hit them, which is not okay. But if imagine my big ass, like I swing, I'm gonna knock the shit out of somebody, dude. I'm a big dude, so it's like, you know, like one.
Because y'all do dumb shit, y'all lie all the time. Like y'all, you lie. Look, it's not just you just catch these hands, right?
Yeah.
It's not lawless.
Yeah.
You lie to me. You know you lied. I'm lying because I'm going to ask you and I'm going to let you tell the truth your damn self. You know what I'm saying? If you know that I know, because I'll stand there with a twinkle in my eye like Santa Claus and be like, did you? Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You already know that I know.
Yeah.
You lie to me. You catching these hands. You better count on it. And if you think I'm right-handed, I'm going to come with a left. Like, I'll be like, it is what it is. Run the risk. Like, fight me. It is
but like 90% of the time, she's going to come with a right. 10% she'll come with a left.
Yeah. That one time you think you're a duck, you're going to catch this hand right coming down. But I don't care.
I hear what you guys are saying. This is after the courting.
Right.
You find out you have a piece of shit.
Yeah.
This is probably why I'm single, because I feel like people, I don't hide anything.
See, that's good. I think that that's good though.
Yeah, that's, I think that's a good quality.
It's not, because if you're, yeah, kind of a, if you're an all-in person, then you're a trustworthy person. Even if it's not lining up with that person, they have to be honest with themselves and go, I can't change him. Because a lot of people probably try to change you, like, oh, I can change him. No, you can't.
Yeah, he told you what it was.
I'm an acquired taste. If you like my style, you love my style. But it's like, I'm not gonna lie to you though.
Okay.
So, but you guys were saying people, oh, put the best foot forward. They want to look good in the beginning. Yeah. Why aren't you good enough? See, that's what I don't understand. That's where the marriage is already fucked up.
Right.
Because you don't believe you're good enough for that person anyway. So you're coming with this facade. You're coming with this. I'm not saying any of you guys are doing it. I'm just saying.
Yeah, like the public, you in general. People in general. I don't get that part about marriage. Right.
Because people say, hey, he was so different or she was so different. How?
But see, the problem. That's a lot of people. Okay, this is the problem that I think in what a marriage is. We want to change the other person. You know
why?
That's what I'm saying. You want
expectations. I think people have expectations on accident in their head. They have, and what's going to happen?
So here's one. Like, I know a lot of people in the Hispanic culture. Their man drink. The female knows that the man drinks. Okay, he drinks a lot. Now they get into the relationship. Now they want to change the man.
Why
do you want to change the man when you already got into the relationship knowing that this person is drunk? So why are you trying to change him? Or it's like a person that's a drug addict. Like, if you already knew he was a drug addict or she was a drug addict when you got into the relationship, right, why are you trying to change them? What is it that you are going to do
Absolutely.
To this person to change? You either are going to accept the person or let them go, right?
Okay, no, 100%. I agree with that.
So it's like that's the problem. A lot of people want to change each other. And that's not good.
Right.
Yeah, if you're trying to change after, that's a battle.
And like I was telling, you know, I have a little girl. I have a daughter and I have nieces. And I tell them, look, if a man comes up to you and the first thing that comes out of their mouth, hey, you're a bitch or you're this or you're that.
Oh, wow.
You know what?
The first thing that comes out of his mouth?
Well,
is there a
no, not the first. I'm sorry. No, but if you're in a relationship
and he
says, fuck you, bitch. Like out of nowhere. It's like, wait a minute. Like, you're calling me out of my name. I tell my daughter, I don't care how gorgeous this guy is. Time for you to get the fuck out of here. Am I right or wrong?
See, that's a catch those hands moment. You see what I'm saying? That's like, call uncle, right?
And we got it.
Yeah.
Right. Like, I don't like. Here's the thing: is I don't like what I have in me. Please don't test it because I know what's in me. And that's my point. It's like, I know I'm crazy. Like, if you're a liar, don't be with me because you finna like get abused. And I don't want to hurt anybody, but I'm not fixing to back down. You lie to me. If you got problems with lying, don't be with me because I'm fixing to find out like Clue.
Women are FBI like agents.
Yeah. I like full-blooded Italian FBI. Got it. Done.
I like what you said about cultural, though, because sometimes there's cultural things that's hard to change.
Agreed.
And, I mean, I just don't understand. If you're going to be with someone, why do you need to change it? Why can't there be like a gradual, we're both getting better? Because it sounds one-sided to me. You know, it's always that person's not good.
So if you get in a relationship, it's what I want. No, a lot of people get that mixed up. It's like, this is what I want in a relationship. No, it's what are we going to bring to the table? What is it that we have? What are we going to have to build an empire together?
Right.
You know, if we have kids, or if you had kids and I have kids, how are we going to integrate our kids together so we can parent these kids? Obviously, I'm not going to be their father, because if they already have a father, I'm not going to be their father. But how am I going to be a father figure to these kids?
Right.
You know, it's all about respect.
Right.
So,
right.
It's just a lot of shit that goes into
it. It just seems like America's got it wrong. Well, our country. Because divorce is high.
Hey, it's. Well, before it was over 50, now it's 60.
So let me ask you a question as men.
Here we go.
So, like, if y'all could ideally build what marriage looks like for you as a person. Maybe I'm not going to ask you because you married Danny Wright. Okay. Casey, if you could build what marriage looks like for you, what does marriage look like for you? If you had no laws, if you could say, like, I'm married to a woman and this is how we live our marriage and you would be ideally happy. This is going to be the next question for you, so think about it.
Yes,
well, me.
How would it change?
Me now?
Yeah.
Wow.
Would, like, polygyny be involved? Like, would you want multiple wives? Would that be something that you would want to do? Like, because
it's not like that. I mean, I love sex, no doubt, but that.
Culturally, that's not a lot of culture, though. That's a lot of culture.
For me, having two women, it would just be very difficult.
Oh, see, like, that's a grown man perspective, though. See, like, you know what I mean? Like, you looking at it from a grown man, like, you're looking at, like, I don't want to fight with two people.
I want to love her.
It's a fantasy.
But if she's like, we can have do something every now and then, I'm like, okay.
So okay, that's
but
that's
I'm
marriage.
Not just saying.
Okay, but that's
but
not
I'm,
qualification.
I'm in love with her. I can't have two loves.
Okay,
I
that's
can't
not
do
qualification.
It. That's okay. Like I can't support two different. I know people support like. I'm calm down.
You really are emotional today. Virgo season is not cute on you. What are you? What are you? What's your sign?
I'm a Saggy.
Okay. I mean,
excuse
I'm sorry.
Me?
I didn't. It was just like a snuff.
We're gonna take a little break right now. We're gonna go talk outside. Talk outside.
Looking at Midorian. Okay. Here's a number.
Honestly, I'm not in marriage mode, so it's hard for me to tell you what type of woman I'd want to marry. I'm still in courting and having someone feel comfortable with me, and I'm comfortable with them.
Okay,
I'm
so what does comfortable look like for you then?
Honesty.
Okay, that's first, obviously. Have you guys ever played the animal game with a woman?
Ooh, what's no, animal?
What is that?
Let me introduce you to a dating technique, okay? Yeah, it's a psychological dating technique, okay? And here's what you do is you play a game, but it's like a harmless game with a woman. So you sit her down, you're getting your little chips and salsa, you're ordering your drinks, and you're like, okay.
So you can do this at a public establishment?
Oh, 100%. Right, and this is going to get them drawn in, okay? 100%. Because you're going to get to know them
you
without
say drawn
getting
in
to know
or
them.
Drunk?
Both. Because they're going to be drinking at this public establishment while you're asking the questions. Take the time asking the questions. Got it? This is the instructions.
I'm with it so far.
Okay. And we'll get back to your answer because I do want to hear it. But like, this is very important for you to learn. Because it teaches you about a person and you get to learn a lot about them. So I'm going to play with you really quick. All right. Ready?
Uh-oh.
I'm going to play with both of you all at the same time, actually.
Hello.
So I knew somebody was making noise.
That's just clit.
Okay.
She likes that.
Why are y'all always wilding with me?
You said it.
I like laugh because I knew it was coming, and then y'all kept on. So like I keep on blushing, and
like,
thank God I
like,
so much.
We're like, oh, it's coming.
See. All right.
There's
I
trigger
see,
words.
I see
it's a
you
trigger.
Guys.
So there's certain trigger words you cannot say to men.
I feel like it's like the hashtag algorithm on Instagram.
It is.
You don't even know, like a hot button, and it'd be like, whoop.
Here
you
know?
Here. Like, that doesn't make sense. Did you know you can't hashtag Italiano?
Here in the mentality show, you cannot say deep.
Balls deep.
There y'all go.
I don't even say it. In normal world, because I know what's going to happen.
Just say deep.
You just balls deep.
There it is. Okay. All right. Okay. So here we
go.
Animal game.
Okay. Here we go. I need to answer.
Okay. So you have to ask a series of questions. So the way you start out is it's always like 5 minutes too
late,
but I love it. I love it. There you go. So you ask your, or so you tell them like, look, can you get comfortable? Can you ask answer these questions? Just super easy questions, but you have to answer like the first thing that comes to mind. So I'm going to ask you your
deep.
Question, right? Like balls deep. There we go.
Deep.
So like the first question that you would ask them, just like as an example, like, look, here's how we're going to do it. Like, look, what's your birthday? And then they just answer their birthday. So like, what's your birthday? December something. Okay. What's your birthday?
July.
There it is. Okay. So here's how you do it. Here's how you're going to play the animal game. You're going to engage them and you're going to ask them. All right. You're going to say, okay, you're in a room and you're by yourself. There's a box in the room. Where is the box?
In the middle.
Oh, where's my box?
Okay, where's your box?
It's probably next to the couch.
All right. What color is your box?
Box color.
Okay.
Tan.
Say white.
Okay.
It's coming from.
Is your box open or closed?
Oh, it's open. I need something to get out of there. if it's closed, that means I ain't got something out of Amazon yet.
Okay. So you be emptying your boxes.
Oh, I got boxes coming to the crib.
Yeah, your boxes got boxes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. You ready to move tomorrow, just in case?
I don't like where you're going. Your face is very sinister. Like I got you.
I love it.
Like I'm in the Matrix right now.
I am 100%. You already chose a pill color. So okay, your box is open or closed?
Mine is closed.
Closed. Okay. Tan, white. Got it.
It's white.
All right. Now there's an animal in the room. What color is the animal?
Tan.
I'm thinking like a lion color.
I was thinking the same.
What's the animal?
Lion. For me, it's a lion.
It's a camel.
Why did you say it sensual?
Camel toe.
Camel toe.
I'm on some different shit right now.
You really are, though. You really are. All right. Now, there's a ladder in the room. Where's the ladder?
Going to my camel.
He looked at me like I should know. It's like going to my camel. It's like, obvious. Dumbass. Don't you see this ladder right here? What color is the ladder?
Oh, shit.
Black.
Okay. All right. Now, tell me how the ladder looks. Is it steep? Is it like, how is it against the wall?
No.
You said no.
It's on my camel. It's going to, the camel lines up with the ladder. I walk on
I
top.
I can't wait to tell y'all how this works out. So, like, I can't wait to say words at the end of this. All right. Okay. All right. All right. How about you? Where's your ladder? How's it look?
My ladder's on the wall.
Okay. Is and it steep? Is it?
It's like.
I don't understand steep.
Your ladder is on your camel?
Angle or?
Listen, is that the perfect length?
Why are you yelling at me right now? He said, listen.
Picture my vibe. There's camel and I need to get on top. I'm not going to jump on top. I'm not LeBron. I'm going to get in there, climb up top.
You needed like a step stool to your camel.
Yep, ride him to the toilet.
Oh, hello.
Okay.
Why is it just the wall going loose?
All right. So here's the thing.
I need pretty feet though, women.
See, hooves. Okay, so here's the thing. Is like when you play this game with people, what you're doing is essentially peeking into their psychology, and you're asking them if the box represents themselves, what color they see themselves, the ladder is their work, how steep they see their work, and then the person is like that they see themselves with is the animal, and the colors represent like how they want to see those people and kind of the vibe that they want from those people and everything else. And the ladder represents like how close it is in proximity to the box and to the person, like how close they want their work. Like you would meet somebody at your work because you'd be comfortable with doing that.
We're not doing that anymore.
See, you see what I'm saying? But he does it though. He says we're not doing it anymore, but he took the camel to the bathroom. You know what I'm saying? Like he totally took the camel to the bathroom. I don't know what you're talking about.
One time it didn't work out well.
Okay. So like, but that's like, it's like a fun day.
But there's some camels on the job, y'all. See how I got excited? Ooh, there's some camels. But I'm being professional.
They got the humps.
Ooh, Lord.
Okay.
Hello.
I can't say no names. Don't say no names.
Okay, don't.
We ain't dropping no names. It's okay. Anyway,
4730 Woodman. Some of y'all are banging.
Okay, he gave the address though. That's generous.
So
of you.
What? So am I freaky? Is he normal? What's going on?
He's like very close, and I feel like probably a serial killer because everything was tan in his world. Everything was tan, and his like workload was hard. So I'm like a little uncomfortable right now.
I'm gonna go sit over there.
Like, look at him. He's like, yes, I am. I'm yes, Dexter.
I
am. You got.
I feel like
it.
My answers influenced him a little bit.
I feel like no. I feel like you just kind of like. Wanna ride a woman and just use one for her humps and then also maybe have like take some money from her since the ladder on the camel.
So how does it benefit the guy though? How do we turn this around?
Because the ladder is on the camel, so your job, which represents your job and which represents your person, they're attached to each other because you put your camel on the ladder. That's how I laughed about it. I was like, look at you taking money from women. I love it. Big energy. Sugar baby, look at you.
This feels crazy.
It does.
You got all of that out of that?
Showed in.
I don't think we use it. We're going to get that.
My ladder's on the wall.
Our ladder's going to be like, yeah, she's trying to get into Menage with time.
Our games are usually like, wrong answer, take a drink. take a drink. Until
take your time and answer your questions. And then let her get drunk as hell. And then
what you did was beautiful, but men are not this thinky.
No, but like all you have to do is just start playing with a woman, talking to her like that in the first date. You learn a lot.
I'm gonna play with a woman.
Stop it. Look at you. You're supposed to be married over there. Playing. We're supposed to be married. We're supposed to be the ones that are like, no, we don't do this anymore.
This is all experiences before marriage. That's how
100%. You know, like I feel like that's one thing I don't have a ton of. I didn't date a ton.
Was good.
Oh, I didn't date a ton.
I think that's good. That's good. Yeah, good for him. Exactly.
Y'all
wow. I mean, it's not much in Alabama.
There's not, except for football teams. You said you were not. I never said I was done. You said you were not. I never said I was done.
She's like Alabama.
Okay, so I don't think I would do that game.
You wouldn't?
I already do my own mental warfare.
What do you do? Go. What's your zhuzh? How do you approach? How do you kill? How do you approach? What do you do when you're hunting and dating? He said,
It's first of all, it's something I'm looking for.
Okay, what are you looking for? What's the genesis?
I can't explain it.
That's you know what? That's right.
What's the genesis?
As a man, we can't explain what we want, but we know that we just want it, and we don't know what the fuck that is. So just letting you know.
And y'all call us crazy.
But it is crazy. But when you find it, you're like, oh shit, this is what I'm looking for.
He's just putting his best foot forward. He knows the fuck he wants. Yeah. What's that?
That's true.
We know what we want.
That's very true. But so, you know what? Sometimes, like, here's the thing. Here's the deal. When you go out on a date, you know the type of woman you're going on a date with. You know who's across the table from you. Because you're like, this chick wants to either fuck.
I agree with that.
This chick is just going to fuck. And you got to, like, understand what the hell is coming out of her mouth. So you got to ask the right questions.
Wait, hold on. See, y'all do things backwards. Y'all be like, she's going to fuck. But we got to understand what's coming out of her mouth.
Not necessarily.
We got to understand what's coming out of his mouth before we want to.
What I'm saying is if you're having a conversation with her, she's throwing red flags out there as to like,
oh, okay,
I like this,
okay,
I like that, I like to do it like this. Then you know what her intentions are. But if she's talking about herself and actually having a decent conversation, you're like, okay, she wants some kind of a commitment. You know what I mean? Obviously, then you find out later on what type of person she wants to be in the bedroom.
Now, know? I've met that's women who me, say though. Things like that they just sometimes want to act like that. Men. Like, I know women who act like men and just want to date, like, for one night, and they'll be like, I ain't even trying to.
You know, some men get intimidated by that, though.
They really do. They're man-eaters. You're like, I'm not trying to husband you. I'm trying to just pass through like a fucking flu. Like,
maybe he was looking for a
week or two, and
she caught him at the wrong time.
Yeah, well, vice versa. She, he, whoever called whoever at the wrong time. It's like a flu. Like I said, you pass around for a week or two and then you're gone.
But those are very rare.
Women?
Who are that honest would be like, listen, I'm just trying to listen. You're talking too much, dude. Yeah. I'm trying to.
I don't know, man. I know a whole rare. Crew. I know a gaggle of them women. That
do you really?
I really do. Shit. They just don't want to be bothered.
No. How many women have you met like that?
Not many.
It's very rare.
I feel like they're really top tier. They don't be bothered. They'd be like, I'll call you. Don't call me. I'll leave you on red. I don't care.
Ooh, that's vicious. Some men
they
can't
really
handle
do.
That.
Because it's all about ego. I didn't date much. Like,
it's all ego.
See, that's the thing. You set. There's too much coming into these dates. Ego, expectations. Just have a conversation.
Exactly. I feel like, do y'all ever see women who just want to do that? And y'all just, like, I'm saying, like, you, if you see a woman and she's talking to you like that and you recognize it, do you ever see her as, like, maybe she doesn't want to, like, I'll just do this tonight and then forget it? Is that, like, how y'all operate, too? Or are you like, nope, I'm done because she's too aggressive?
No, the thing is, it just changes your perspective. Mm-hmm. It just changes her perspective of her. It's like, okay, well, I'm not going to respect her. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm going to see her as, like, now she's just an object where, like, she just wants to go and fuck around. You know, I'm not going to take her serious. Like, oh, okay, we can talk about it. You know?
That's what she wants.
She doesn't want you to be serious with her. It's more like a one-night stand or like I'm gonna hit and that's it. You know what I mean? Maybe a couple times. And that's it.
Hit it, quit it.
Yeah, hit it and
some
quit it.
Some women are cool with that. Some women are very cool with that. Like they just, like I said, they're very cool with that. And true. I think that they're just very like, because I've met women who like go in the dating world just like men do kind of viciously and they're just there for that.
Agreed.
Isn't that wild though? I just didn't know that was a thing so much because like I said, I didn't date as much. So like when I found that out, I was a little trippy. But y'all seem to be very comfortable with the conversation. I'm thrown off.
No.
I think men say they want that.
Yeah.
But when it gets put it right there, sometimes they'll be like,
They don't know what to do.
Most guys don't know what to do.
A lot of guys.
Yeah, because, like, what if she doesn't catch feelings? What if she is just there to, like, you know what I mean? And then go. Like, what if it is that? Like, what if it is what it is? And she's just like, listen, I'm just trying to hook up with you.
In
like,
the men's world, it's very rare. It's very rare.
It's a mind game.
I know a couple very women rare. Like that. It's wild. But it's like, rare. I do. But they, like, honestly, I feel like they're older, have kids.
I was going to say that.
Yeah. I agree.
They have
that.
Their own money. They don't need that. Anything. Yeah. Do you understand? Back like, when women I was who young, don't need anything are lethal.
Yeah.
If anyone I could think of that was like that, they were older women.
Yeah. Because they know what they want.
Like already just, married and divorced. Yeah. And like,
because they know what they want. They know exactly what they want. A youngster's more like, oh, well, I want the picket fence.
All of the ones I'm thinking about 100% are like that. Like, just lethal. They'd just be like, listen, I'm not, like, I just chose you, but I'll unchoose you. I'll unclick you in 1 second. Watch it. Yeah. Watch. Throw me one bit of a bite of the net. I'm like, yeah. Like, click, clack. I'll like, just like an Amazon you. Cart. You know what I mean? Like,
but it's like, and then nowadays, nowadays with the phone shit, it's like, how many fools do you have on your phone that I might not be
on? I change
one.
My number all the time.
You gotta. I think dating, like, you gotta leave that out.
Exactly. Yeah.
I hate you. It's like such a faint dog. I change my number all the time. I'll be out here changing my number all the time.
I really thought there was a dog outside the window.
My life was seriously, it was so faint.
That
was a question.
That was reference to the women that he was talking about.
Oh, okay.
Bitches. You change your number all
that? All the time.
Uh oh.
I don't love it.
I just have 4 phones.
No, because I feel like, you know how, like, you see, look at you with 4 phones.
Yeah,
but see, I have 1 phone. I just, like, look.
Trap.
Because we do this, birds. Like, right here, and then I go and I work with artists, like, and then I go and everybody gets my number inevitably, and then I got people hitting me up, and I have to keep my phone on silent. I have a family, but they'll be, like, artists hitting me up 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm not trying to have it.
3 in the morning?
Y'all better hit me on my gram.
That is not an artist.
It is. They'll be up, like, wild in the middle of the night. Like, it's the craziest thing ever. And, too, like, I have a lot of East Coast friends. So it's
so
like,
they should be
it's
really
like
in bed.
4 o'clock in the morning, right. It's like 7 o'clock, you know, like, yeah. So it's like wild. So
shout out to all my East Coast friends, too.
I love the East Coast. Let's go.
There you go.
First of all, we got a lot to talk about.
He said he was done. He's not. I told you.
Never
not.
Done.
Never. Y'all heard it here first.
So what is it that a man wants in a relationship? You asked the question.
Yeah. What do you guys really want? Like, what are you looking for when you find wife material? Like, when you go out and you say, what are your three checks? What's your three checks?
You want me to tell you my three checks?
Give me your three checks.
Ooh, I like
one,
this.
One, two, three.
The one, the first one for me is trust.
Oh, see, he said honesty too, so I feel like that's same. Trust. That's synonymous.
But trust for me is you
top
have
tier.
Yeah, that's top tier
for me. I feel like that's, is that everybody in the room?
Yeah.
I think so, because like if you can't trust them, if I can't lay down next to you and be comfortable and go to sleep, like,
there's no point.
Okay. There's no point in being with that person.
There really isn't. And like, do y'all feel like, I feel like I could love anybody, but for me.
Yes.
Anybody?
You feel like, no, like I'm saying, like if I love you and I'm like in a relationship with you or whatever else, like it doesn't have to fit so much criteria. Like again, right. A je ne sais quoi with guys or whatever else. Some people like, they'd be like, you're attracted to him, but like, yes, I don't know why, like, but this he got son.
What swag?
You know what he got?
100%. Like there's like, yeah, 100%. Like there are people there are people I'm not attracted to that you should be, but I'm not.
Right.
But like, you know, I think honesty is a huge thing for everyone. If you can't wake up next to him, you can't go to bed next to him, you can't trust him, listen, no.
I agree with you there. See, the next thing for me will be is I want to be able to desire the person I'm with.
What makes them desirable?
Oh, good question.
Follow up with that.
I think the desire would be like, I want to say sex appeal, but it's just...
So like random nudes in your inbox? Like where it's like,
yes,
hey,
yes.
Babe, it's like my wife on the... It's her vagina, don't look! You know what
all
I mean?
Of a yeah, all of a like sudden, yes. it's one of those where like they keep you guessing. Like, this is for you, babe. I thought about you, boom. You know what I mean?
It is. So DM the nudes when you're still married. The men still want the nudes.
For me, it's a fantasy kind of thing. Like, hey, my wife is my fantasy or my girlfriend.
100%.
That's my fantasy. 100%. This is the person that I'm going to be with, and I want her to feel as comfortable with me. And it's like all of a sudden, like, boom, you know what? Here you go. Just keep me interested.
Do you know why I dress like this and why I have four children? Why I work out all the time? Because I want Sean Godala, when he's at work as a nurse, to slap a bitch across the face if he tries to approach him. I want him to be like, don't ruin this for me, you bitch. Do you hear me?
Don't you
fucking ruin this for me. Though. You get away from me. Because look, I've had four kids, but like I definitely try so hard to make sure that happens. So I agree with that because I work on that myself. So I agree with that.
So, hey, you know what?
So you trying to make him go for five? Number five?
Yeah. No. We got them two.
Give her another baby.
You're like, no. And you know what? You know what?
Beautiful kids too.
Let me say this. Let me say this though, because in a relationship, even as man, we let ourselves go. We get too comfortable with who we're with.
Everyone at some point does.
And I get that.
There are phases, like the moon. Everyone goes through phases.
And I get that. But see, the thing is this, though. Why can I continue to be me and I want to be able to be sexy for you? Does that make sense? Like, you're doing it. Why, you know?
He does. Like, I feel like my husband, I feel like it's almost like a, when you set by example and not by word, you really do get a lot further in life. You know what I mean?
I agree.
Like when you work out every day, your partner will start to work out every day. If you don't bitch at them and if they don't, then they don't. But at the same time, like they might turn into a different person. If they do, you might get left, lady. Like it is what it is. Yep. Stay stagnant and die. That's what it is.
And I tell my, I think the third one for me would be charm. Like charming each other.
What's
like,
charming?
Like dating. Like I feel like we gotta set aside, because we have kids. We gotta like set aside trying to be
selfie
dating
time.
Yeah, selfie time.
Selfie time.
We gotta date each other. Like go on a date and just do whatever. People, you understand? So I don't know. Just set a like date night. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
And be freaks.
Basically, you want to keep it romantic. Yes.
Right. You want to have spice still in your relationship where you don't just stay at home on the couch and you're chilling in sweats. You want to be able to look at her across from the dinner table with candlelight.
But you know what? Even I personally think that even a female that has like, that's at home with like sweats and just like a baggy t-shirt, I think that's sexy.
No, it is. But you don't want to do it all the time, right? Like, exactly. You don't want to eat a hamburger the rest of your life even though hamburger's bomb, right?
Yep.
Exactly. Do you know what I'm saying? So, like, you want to be able to go across from it. Like, you want to look at her, like, dress up and go out and, like, you know, hang out.
Fuck
and just, yeah. That's what you want to do. Exactly. You still want to date while you're married.
Exactly.
Got it. Three ticks for you, mister. Go ahead.
Well, first of all,
first of all, honesty. Second of all,
this is what if I want. And the woman?
Yeah. You said, first of all, honesty. So we all went
honesty. Right? Honesty. Mm-hmm. We all there. Blah, blah, okay. Blah. Next, I need to see them feet. Because obviously, I'm attracted to you. No. It's a real talk.
I agree.
It's a real talk.
I understand.
Who said they agree?
I understand what he's saying.
I don't feel like honest, I do.
This is Casey, though.
It really is. It really is.
Honestly, obviously, I'm attracted to you.
Okay.
My mother put something in my head as a child about women with who take care of their feet. I'm sorry.
At least you know where I came from. Who had a very huge like fetish for feet.
It's not a fetish.
Well, I'm just saying, I never noticed it. I never noticed women's feet until I met this guy, right? And after that, I noticed how many women don't take care of their feet.
I won't touch them.
I mean, a lot of women do, of course.
I'm not being stuck up.
I didn't realize that a lot of them
it's like
don't.
A horror story.
Like, yes, like, fuck, what the fuck?
And then women, yeah. I'm not saying...
If your feet are worse than mine, but we have a problem. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Dun, dun, dun. I just don't know people like that. Like, I don't know. Like, that sounds like hobbit feet, and I don't know.
I don't care about how long toes, short toes.
No, I'm just saying like the way that they would just like be scraggly because like you just take back roads on them feet. Like, you don't really wear shoes or nothing. Like, I don't know. Like talons. So I'm giving you hooves. Feet.
And there's three.
This, yeah, you're on the last one right now. Go ahead.
Wow, this is deep. Because
it really
balls
is.
Deep. Balls deep.
I did it too with you guys. It's so good.
It's good, Kay. Okay. I like okay. that. It's good.
I love it. It's all like.
Well, I'm not there yet. My mind's there because I've been
scattered ass.
But
it's okay.
I would like her to be creative.
I like that. I like that.
Yes.
I like that because creative does kind of fall in line with everything, and creative will keep spice and everything kind of covers a lot. It's a good broad spectrum. Like, she'll be fun for birthdays, she'll be fun for holidays, she'll be fun for, you know, all of the things that are like mommy and like, because like, look, one of the things I'm big on, like one of the things I love is I wake up in the morning before everybody else because like I like to wake up on my own terms. Having young kids, waking up to screaming is not good. Right?
God, so I said,
I agree.
I send my coffee, I get up early, I turn on the fireplace, like if it's cold, like it's getting cold, I do the whole last fireplace thing, and then I set like a candle, like a candle, like right now it's like pumpkin spice stuff, so like it's, and then the morning like I'll make biscuits for the kids, so it's like everyone likes waking up at home, right?
Can I ask you a question? I have my
hand go, 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 go.
Do you want him to notice all that?
It's not that I want him to notice all that, it's that they're not going to notice all that, but when you wake up in the morning and you're home, you fucking know. Do you know what I mean? And if that's your home and you wake up to candles and fireplaces and warm biscuits, you
did
fucking
your mom
know
do
when
that
you
for
home.
You?
Yeah.
Okay. Because that's
my mom was cool. But my mom had a time. My grandmother did that too.
Yeah. But that's
it really is. Like I had a really cool holiday experience. We did all the cookies making. We like we had the videos. Yeah, and so I do it with my kids and I love it. Like I love them loving being home. So it's like when you know you're home. So when his definition of home, when he comes home after a long day of work and he smells candles, like I bet you he notices it more than I realize he notices it. You know what I mean? Like when you come in, it's like, oh man, the house smells good. It smells like homemade meal. Like it smells good.
Oh, yeah, that's
you
a
notice
good smell.
It. You know what I mean? Like I you agree. Walk in, it smells like your mama's house.
That's
and
an excellent
garlic
smell, actually.
Is like garlic and butter together, and it's like, ooh.
I don't
want to
come home and
pie.
Smell like hot phone. Like
you don't
been
want to.
Or just ass. Smells like ass in the fucking. Like, oh,
yeah, the phone been working.
No, you wanna like when you see your kids laughing, happening. Yeah, you wanna do all that.
But see, that's the thing. I think, and that's one thing that. We as human beings, we want our alone time as well. We have
do.
Our partner,
we
but
do.
We also want our alone time.
Like and it has to be that way. You have to encourage.
Yeah.
Have a go make friends.
Yeah.
Right, because it's called codependency. If you don't.
But see, the problem with a lot of people out there is that they get jealous.
Yeah, but that's to where trust is number one.
That, exactly.
See, that's what I'm saying. And when that's gone, you should just really abandon ship. Like, get the hell out the relationship. You can't do it. And don't even come back 10 years later. Don't do it.
Yeah. I love his relationship.
Rosie!
I mean, I haven't met everybody's, but there, I see how they talk to each other. I dig it.
Rosie?
I feel
I
it.
Just love the name.
And you know that's a trial and error. That one just like, you've been through the stuff. Rosie's been through stuff, and you've got to come and talk.
I like it. Yes. I like all I've heard about Rosie. I've not met Rosie, but I like what I heard about Rosie.
She's definitely
a thug. Rosie's been silent on the show lately.
Oh, she's in school. She's in school. She's been in school, so I'm proud of her. Like I told her, hey, baby, you handle your business. And that's it.
See, that's good, though. That's good relationship.
You know, a lot of men don't do what you just do.
I know.
You got to encourage, man. Like it's. I told her. This is what I told her. I want to build an empire together. This is what we're here for.
It's very important. It's very important.
There's too much machismo with men, though.
Especially in the Hispanic culture.
And in the Black culture.
You just really have to, in any culture, because honestly, you have any and whatever culture. I gotta be honest with you. It's like one thing that you gotta have the same kind of goals, because like I stayed at home as a mother for a very long time now. You know the career was popping. Like she was good.
Yeah, I know.
She was doing all right.
She
canceled it. She canceled
when
she got to be a mother.
The marriage thing, I was like, whoa.
She went home to be a mother. Like, it, look, I you know, laugh, joke, all that good stuff, but, like, my children come first,
always,
right? And then
always.
They went to school all four.
Always.
2 days ago. So, at the end of the day, it's like, that was priority, getting them there, then I came here, right?
Nice.
But, like, you have to have the same goals. Some men want to, wait, well, what happened?
I'm with you. I'm on the ride.
Okay, he laughed. I was like, what happened? Okay. But some people want a woman that's working. And if you don't want to work, or if you don't want to go to school, if like you want to raise your kids, if that's what you do,
if that makes her happy, I'm happy.
Yes.
Right? Like, it's like I didn't, not that I didn't want to work. It's just like I had the opportunity to stop working. And like, I love that because that was right. That was for me. Like, I love being at home with my kids, being there for my kids. That's my first priority right now. Right?
But your husband is very supportive of you.
Right. That's what I'm saying. It's like, that's why you have to be on the same page. Exactly. Right, you gotta be same page. Like, that's what I'm saying. It's like you and Rosie be on the same page. It's beautiful. Like, that's what's one thing, because some people don't see that. Like, some people will be like, "Oh, I thought she was going to still work," and she's like, "Oh, I thought I was going to stay home because that's what her family did." Right, and no one talked about it until like, because that's one thing you really don't know when you have your mate is how they're going to be as a parent, and that can really turn you the hell off.
Agreed.
And it's stuff that was ingrained in them as children that you really can't undo.
Well, you know. Being a parent doesn't come with a manual.
Oh, well, no, it doesn't.
We just invent shit that happens, right?
Or you do what your parents did.
Exactly. Or you do what your parents did.
Or you do exact opposite what your parents did.
Yeah. I did the opposite. I mean,
you're like, and then you're like, you know what? I'm never going to be like my parents. Then you're like, oh shit, I'm like my parents.
Well,
like,
we're always going to carry some sort of likeness of them. Do you know what I mean? Even if we try to change the whole picture or anything else, it's still gonna, the apple still won't fall far from the tree, even if it's on a hill. You know, it's still gonna be the same.
I think some cultures treat women wrong. I'm from a Jamaican culture.
Okay.
And it's
what cultures treat women wrong?
Huh?
What cultures, in your opinion, treat women wrong?
I can only speak about Jamaican culture.
And do you think that they treat women wrong?
I feel like there's not a respect level like equalness.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen, I mean, but now today's time is beautiful for some things. Women have more empowerment, but what I grew up seeing, oh, hell no.
Yeah.
Right.
And that, I think that, see, I was the kid that was, lived in Jamaica, then came to the United States. So I seen my mother learn stuff like, oh, it's not supposed to be like this.
Right. So is she like old school?
Old school in what way? I don't know.
Like, is she like very Jamaican? Like, is she very
Jamaican? She's very Jamaican, but she used to be, like he used to control.
That's what I was saying.
Like,
is that
I get this. I give you that. Mm-hmm. And she came to this country. And she was like, "Wait a minute, so it's not gonna be like this."
And that's the way it is in the Hispanic culture as well.
Like, mm-hmm. We're similar, very similar,
very similar. So, mm-hmm. And that's the problem. Like, when you're old school, when you have that old school mentality thought, and that's what I think a bunch of this shit goes to shit, because like, you need to agree on how are we gonna get to this goal, but I'm gonna be in charge, like.
Can I ask you this?
I think gender roles always fall back, and I hate to say that because that could be an unpopular opinion a lot of times.
Say it again one
more
time.
I do. I think gender roles always fall back. I think in some way you always, like, a panic happens, you're going to look at your husband and be like, what are we finna do? You know what I mean? Like, when nothing is like you might support, but like you're going to look at him to make a plan so you can figure it out together. You're going to talk to, like, it is what it is. And if like you're in the middle of a war situation and like a bomb goes off, you're going to watch a man jump on a woman. You're going to, and his kids. It's just what it is.
Yeah,
like,
but.
And like, you know, like, I just feel like, I don't feel like it has to be that way necessarily, I guess is what I'm saying. But I feel like a lot of times it does happen. And when like men, like, I've watched women lose respect for men, and that's when it gets out of pocket, and
that's,
they flip,
way out
the
of pocket,
roles
then.
Well, flip, and you can see it when it does, because she no longer respects them, and you can see the respect when it just drains from her mouth talking
to him. And the kids
see
it too.
Yeah. Oh man, but you can just see how much those roles flip, where it's like, if there's like respect and love there, like, a woman really does show that so well, but when she doesn't, ugh.
And that's a problem. That is very true. I agree with that, because you know, in my situation, my previous relationship, like, money was an issue, and it's like, you know, we started off humble, and then we started off doing things together. And then when you got a job where you saw a little bit more money,
mm-hmm.
and it's like, she was making more money than I was.
So she
like,
put a value on the relationship.
She put a value on the relationship. You have to match what I'm making. And it's like, wait a minute.
Oh,
like,
that's tough.
That's the expectations
and
right
that,
there.
And
then, you can't
and
do that.
And that's what I told her. I was like, look, like, I want to be where you're at, but you got lucky at the position that you got because... You know,
he said you got lucky,
and yeah, because, well, it's a long
dun,
story,
dun,
but,
dun.
But it's a long
that's
story.
That's where the divorce happened. Yeah,
but,
that's,
but and that's the thing. Like, I told her, like, you got lucky because of your looks.
He added that part in too. That was just, yeah.
And it's true.
That's where episode Snap starts.
And that's the problem, because a lot of people started, you know, mind fucking her. Were like, oh well, she will work in working in a men's department, in a high end men's department, and a lot of guys will come in there with money. So, you know, obviously they'll buy. And she was working on commission and salary. So it's one of those where like, I'm making money. And all these motherfuckers are buying shit because I'm showing them stuff, and they're buying it because they think they're gonna like say what's up to me. Does that make sense? So she was making a lot of money.
So she took that macho thing. That's
when you told her that,
flipped it on you. I told you.
She started tripping when you told her that you said you're making more money because of your looks.
She knew that's the reason.
She knew.
She knew that was the reason.
Well, she's okay.
And I told her like, but then I told her like, okay, so here's the deal. Like, what you have to understand is, just because you're making this amount of money doesn't mean that you're going to make this amount of money all the time. Oh, yes. You know, so it was
sales.
It was
true.
And it's sales. So it's like, but you also got to understand, you got all these fools hitting on you, but you got to come home to me. And it's like, and I'm the one that's not making enough money for you. So like all these other fools that are making all this money is a fantasy.
So was she throwing it in your face?
I remember you also talking about there was a job done. So that I think.
Why
that
are
takes
you saying words like I'm gonna be offended? Go ahead.
No,
say
I'm not.
No. Like, say what you need to say.
She had a boob job too.
There it is.
Yeah. And a lot of women.
I have one recently.
That affects the head too.
In what way?
I agree.
It goes.
Oh, so that's
No. Like I honestly, here's the thing. No. Here's what happened to me. I haven't opened a door since May 27th.
Yeah, but
for myself.
Yeah, but you would have said men or women before that.
100%. No, like without a doubt, without a shadow of a doubt. But like, no, men are women now. It's the strangest thing ever. You get like all the craziest, like, yeah, you get like, people are so nice to me. So it does change how people treat you. So you're like, oh, should I have clout now? Cause I have, who knew how boobs were like,
okay, so that's
get
what,
some,
that's
try
what
some,
it
try
is.
Some on. People treat you differently.
The head gets bigger cause you got clout now.
No, but like it, people do treat you differently. So it could change you, as I'm saying. Like I could see it being like, okay, I can see where you're going with that. Cause it's like people have treated me differently.
I think I'm going to get a breast.
You should change people.
Bruce Jenner?
Yeah, right.
You should.
Or Caitlyn.
Caitlyn Jenner.
Caitlyn, that's right.
I just think that was part of the problem too.
Yeah,
agree.
Could be. Because I know some girls who have done that too. But like the thing is I feel like if you go into it, like look, like I said before, like I worked out all the time. Like I kind of wanted to get to a place where I had filled back in what I had before I had four kids, because I breastfed my kids.
Yeah, but this.
But no, I'm saying like if you're good in your situation, whatever,
yeah, but
that won't change
your situation. She was using it as to put him down, like.
Well,
yeah.
Like I'm saying, like maybe she got that boob job for work and not for him.
Oh, that's crazy.
Well, it was for her, but then she used it to her advantage to get to where.
Yeah. I mean, I've known girls who are like probably the sweetest girls and that had no like dating issues. Like they didn't, you know what I mean? They were just sweet girls. They didn't date a lot. They got boob jobs and all of a sudden they're just wild, like crazy.
Because that's a new toy.
You know what I'm saying? It just changes the mind. Like, no, I don't feel that way about it. Like, I do feel like I'll look different, but I don't feel like it's like something that, it's not like a weapon I need to wield to like look at my boob power.
But
hold
on, though. But I think that it is in your mind. It is an advantage on a female, though.
It is.
Well, yeah.
It definitely is a new
toy.
That's.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah.
What happened?
You got 2 minutes.
No, we got to find a better way to signal like we're running out of time.
Oh, I know, right? Like I was in my head. Yeah.
Hey, everybody,
we got 2 minutes.
All right, so okay.
I'm sorry, I interrupted the whole vibe.
No.
Why is it always me?
No, it's not. So honestly, I think everyone boils down to honesty. Honesty is so huge. So if you're dating, being honest and being who you are from
I
the very beginning.
Need to stay honest too. Yeah. After you get in the relationship.
Hey, we can continue this conversation next week. It's all good. It's a good conversation.
It's interesting.
It is.
I was going to say something about boobs.
Very interesting. Bob?
Cool. I remember one time I picked my son at the airport, and as soon as he got in the car and we saw this pretty girl, he said, boobs! I was like, what the fuck?
Like,
what are you yelling at the car boobs for? He's like, I don't know. I like her boobs. Well, don't yell.
Don't yell
that
you like
her
boobs.
We have a listener that said women have got confidence, but I don't think that's... What do you call when boobs give you built confidence? I mean,
like pseudo confidence, like
yeah, okay,
it gives
yeah,
you
yeah,
like
yeah,
it was
yeah.
more for her though, because she feels like she's right. okay with her parents.
Hey, but here's the question: does that make women more superficial?
No, because not if you got a different body, what? And like if like if you like got like the body of like Ryan Reynolds tonight, and then people started treating you differently.
Well, their expectations meaning
like, right, like if your body totally changed overnight, like it's I don't think that they go in with that mentality. I think it just happens to them, and then they realize they get more attention, and because they don't get enough attention somewhere else, or because they have a lack of attention, because they have a problem,
don't
they
do need it for attention. Attention,
right? But a lot of women do. Right, mm-hmm. for the wrong
gonna,
reasons.
But regardless so of the that, fact,
if they do it for the wrong reasons, then it's going to end up. You know,
whether it's good or bad, it's still right. going to get you some attention. Whether it's good or bad attention,
true.
Like, no
right,
matter what,
don't,
yeah. true. You got a button for that.
It's how you react to this attention, though.
Yeah,
right.
If you become like, oh yeah, fuck you.
But no, you already not, know yeah. your head's going to blow up regardless. Yeah,
you get gassed just because your team's winning now and people don't know how to act right.
Honda yeah. Civic.
On that note,
we
have 1 minute left. Goodbye. Well, sorry, first, can't talk about it.
You guys did a great job. I'm just going to end on this. The topics were things that women want from their men, and you guys covered everything organically. It's crazy.
I love that energy.
It's good.
It's big stuff.
Trust. No, she wants to be known that she's loved. Honest, everything you guys did it. It's crazy.
We did it.
But I think
we
the biggest
knew the mission.
One,
that's why we understood the assignment.
The biggest one is going to be respect. Respect,
yeah, absolutely.
Respect.
You've got to keep respect.
You really do. If you, if, as a man, if you can keep respect alive, you gonna keep that Don Juan appearance. So she'll do whatever. If she starts to disrespect you, it's a wrap. Go ahead, divorce her.
I agree.
It's a wrap.
And fuck.
On that note, we're brought to you by Bologna and Manukian LLP. Man, we love these people that've been in our corner from the jump.
Yeah. Thank you guys.
They're the best. I want to thank Leah.
Thank you for having me.
747-444-444-444.
That's right.
Yes. Love the vibe. Great energy.
Yep.
So good.
I learned a lot today, honestly.
For a minute past.
Yeah.
Love you guys. Bye.
Hey, you guys. Thank you very much for joining us. Spotify, all everywhere you are, all the podcasts are at. You guys know what to download us. You guys have a good one. See you guys next week. Love you guys.
Peace out.
Peace. If you love yourself first, then the love is going to be easy to love someone else.
Yes, sir.
Bye.
Later.
One.
You're listening to The Mentality.